Ooh.
What is this?
Hey guys! Welcome or welcome back. I'm Anna.
And I'm Chu.
And we're Inca Reacts. Today we're going to be doing a bit of a K-pop catch-up. We have a bunch of different, mostly girl groups or female artists.
All girl groups.
Yeah, sorry. All girl groups.
And female artists.
And we're just excited, so let's dive in.
All right, the next song we are going to be watching is Nmixx's Dash. I have been spoiled on this song because of TikTok. I see their challenge everywhere. So I know the chorus. I don't know anything else from this song.
I don't know anything about this. I'm very excited.
Do you listen to a lot of Nmixx?
I've listened... I don't listen that much.
You're missing out on some good music.
I listen when it like comes up on a playlist or something, but I don't like seek it out necessarily.
Okay, let's hope you like this one.
Okay.
What I love about Nmixx, their instrumentals are so good.
Also, I really like the members of Nmixx.
Lily is one
so
of the
funny.
Taewon is hilarious. They look so good. I love these outfits.
Ooh.
And their vocals.
Hold on, I'm turning this up on my.
The vocals in Nmixx's songs are so good.
Ooh.
Ooh. I don't fully know everyone's name. I think this is Bae. Correct me if I'm wrong, please.
Ooh.
The
I love the vocals.
Yeah. Lily, her voice.
Ooh.
I love how funky it is, too. I think I said this during one of our other reactions. When a song has horns, I don't know why, I just love it.
Ooh. I love smooth vocals.
Mm-hmm. What's it called? The ad-libs are amazing.
Yeah.
Too.
The harmonies in the background are so good.
Oh, so good.
Ooh.
She took off. Girl, where are you going?
What the fuck?
What was that?
That's Taewon, right? With the short...
Yeah.
Yeah.
Short hair. I love Taewon. She's freaking hilarious.
Ooh.
What is this?
An exchange of.
This is a lot like I'm pretty sure they were flying on rocks then too.
I just wanna continue
my pace. Ooh, I like that. That was cool.
Ooh, I love that.
They're so
good. Oh my god.
They're so good.
That, genuinely, that was so fucking good.
Yeah. Oh my god. I remember when, sorry, I paused it. There's still like...
30 seconds left.
Oh, that's cool how they're crumbling up at the top. Wow, they're so creative.
You know, JYP does his false ending sometimes, like that, like with Semi-Free.
It doesn't look like
okay.
There's anything else. All right. Wow. It's been kind of torture to know the chorus.
And not hear anything
and
else.
And not be able to listen to it because we're doing this. That was... I remember when JYP first announced Nmixx, they did that black version of the album.
Yes.
And their slogan was like, your new favorite girl group. And like low key.
They weren't wrong.
They're up there. They're up there. They're so amazing.
I feel like I've been a sinner for not paying more attention to them. Because if this is the quality stuff that they're putting out, vocals obviously are important to anyone who's a K-pop fan. But for me, it's like important.
Yes.
And just the vocals are so smooth. The harmonies in the song were so good in the background. They were so nice. It was all so good. And it's so funny because the instrumental was good too. But what carried it was the vocals. That was like what carried the song. And it was such easy listening. For something that has like a talking chorus, which I find tends to not be as easy listening. Mm-hmm. This was so this is so easy to listen to. You know?
It was super easy to listen to. Even with like the hard-hitting like percussion and the sharp trumpet sounds. It was just because their voices are so smooth.
Yeah.
It was just so enjoyable to listen to.
That was so good. Holy shit.
You need to listen to more.
I will. Maybe we'll do a deep dive one day.
Ooh, we could. Because I also haven't listened to everything they put out.
Yeah. I'd like to get to know the members.
I've pretty much only listened to OO, which low-key I loved.
I didn't hear it, I don't think.
I've listened to Dice, but I could not
I did hear
you.
Dice.
I don't remember.
I know Dice, but I don't remember how it goes. It'd be good to listen to all their songs.
And their song, it's like Love, Hate, or something like that.
Oh, I know what you're talking about. Yeah.
Yeah. That was one of my favorite songs of the year, last year. So that's pretty much all I know about their music. I need to listen to more.
Me too.
Hoo-hoo, solo time.
Oh, God. Oh, God.
Oh, God. I'm nervous.
I'm so sorry. We're going to have to watch this twice. I know it.
The next song we're going to be listening to is Seola's Without You. Anna, talk to me.
I feel like I should preface this with my alt group is WJSN. Like, Cosmic Girls, Uju Sonyeo, they are my alt group. And Seola is my bias wrecker. So I have been looking forward to this from the moment it was announced. And also, I've been desperate for music. Any sort of music. So I am so fucking...
From Uju Sonyeo.
Yes. I'm so excited. We're going to have to watch this twice. I'm sorry. I'm prefacing it now. Because I need one time to absorb it all. And then one time to actually listen. You know?
Okay.
I
also love Uju Sonyeo. They're one of my favorite girl groups. Not nearly as much as Anna. Because she's obsessed. But I'm super excited. I'm super nervous. But let's just get into it.
I'm so excited. Come on, lead vocal. Ooh. Ooh. Whoa.
Ooh, okay, I was not expecting this type of content.
I didn't even listen to any teasers because I knew I was going to react to it. Oh my God.
I like it. I like it already. This is like... She's, my type of vibe.
She is so pretty. She's so unreal.
Pretty. Ooh. Whoa.
Ooh. Yeah. Bring it down.
I wonder where this is going to go.
Bring it down. Where are we going? Oh, I love that.
Ooh, Angel.
She's unreal looking. With or without
you. Oh, I love the vocal layering.
Me too.
Ooh. I don't know why. That outfit is so good on her.
I know, it's a t-shirt and pants.
Okay, she's taking this like three separate directions so far.
Ooh.
Okay.
Okay, we're bringing it back up.
Yeah.
I feel overstimulated. Like...
Oh, okay.
I'm trying to, like, listen and focus.
This is like IU's Above Time. Oh my god, it's so much like IU's Above Time. Not musically, the music video.
I haven't seen that music video.
Oh. I love her voice.
Her tone's so good.
Yeah.
She's one of my favorite vocalists ever. Ooh. Yeah, what's the bridge?
I want to hear her belt.
Okay.
Is it going there? No, I don't think so.
It's okay. Ooh. Who's she holding hands with? Herself?
Who is that?
Who is this woman? Sorry, actually, that's me.
Oh, for a second, I thought it was Yeji.
It's her, I think.
From ITZY. I think it's her. Wow. It's her birthday?
Happy birthday, Seola. No, it's not.
Happy birthday.
First off, it's crazy coming into this because I've watched so many of, like, Seola's covers, and like, you know, she posts on her Bubble like music recommendations, stuff like that, and it's insane. First off, I'm just so proud of her, just the little fangirl right now. I'm so proud of her, you know. But also, this comeback could have went a million different ways. I had no idea where she was gonna go with this, because her music tastes are really diverse, and it can like go from like upbeat to slow or whatever. And I was like, I don't know where she's gonna go with this. I'm incredibly glad she went this way with it. Something a little less, a little more stripped back on the instrumentals, and something that she could just sing on. Cause like her voice is so good. Well, you're.
I love.
Yeah.
I love the song. I love how. There was like three different themes, I guess. There was like a teen love type of feel. Then there was a slow, like acoustic version. Then there was like a rock.
Yeah.
Version. I loved how she moved between those. I really wanted to hear her belt though.
I know. I do think it could have sounded
close,
out of place a little bit if she just belted, but.
There was moments where I thought it could work, but. I really wanted to hear her like show off those vocals a little bit more.
I love heavy guitar songs, or songs that like instrumental is mostly guitar, and this had that. It's like guitar,
yes, it did.
In three different ways, you know. Like, and I think we should just watch it again and then I'll say more.
This intro is interesting too.
The way it swells into like acoustic. God, her voice is just beautiful.
It is.
This is my favorite fit from the music video, and it's nothing.
It's so simple.
Well, it's so upbeat in this first part.
Yeah, it is.
Her face card has never declined in her life. Oh, I actually just got chills on my body for some reason.
No, the sandcastle. Those earrings are crazy.
I like this.
This is my other favorite.
Yeah.
I love how she comes in there too. And this talking part is so, I don't know. It's so satisfying. Don't be angry.
God, she's unreal looking.
She's a very pretty girl. The switch to acoustic there is so interesting. And then into rock. Well, like electric guitar. By the way, in I Use Above Time, someone's holding a house, looking into it, and I Use climbing up a ladder.
Oh my god.
That's why I was like, this is exactly the same. I love this talking part.
Yeah. The layers are so good.
Yeah. And that, like, vocal editing.
Ooh.
This is going on the playlist for sure.
I love being able to hear all the layers in her, like...
I love how clear her voice is.
Back to acoustic. We gotta...
I literally thought this was Yeji.
That falsetto is so gorgeous.
Yeah. I wish you couldn't hear the motorcycle in that one little section.
Oh, that little section?
Yeah. It's probably just a music video thing, but...
Yeah.
So good.
Oh my god.
Happy birthday.
Actually, the second listen was really good for me. Because now I feel like I
developed
more... On the second listen, I was less overstimulated, and I was actually mostly just trying to listen. The song, it's so funny. I specifically have a playlist on my Spotify titled Songs That Sound Like Summer Youth. Mm-hmm. And this song this feels like that.
Summery. That's why I said it's kind of like a teen love type thing. I think most of those movies are set in like summer.
Yeah. Like
but it had a very teen youth type of feel.
Like one of my favorite genres of songs are songs that you roll your windows down to and just when you're driving. And this feels like that.
It does.
It feels like what's so funny is it's relatively upbeat, but it doesn't seem perfectly happy. Like the mood of the song does not feel that like perfectly happy.
The tone of her voice sounds sad in some parts, and like the color grading maybe too affects that, because it's all like blues and whites.
She has such like sentimentality in her voice. Mm-hmm. Well, that's what they literally call her, like Kamsung vocal, like, you know, she's that for Uju Sunyo. So like you can feel it in this.
Yeah.
And I like much prefer, like, you can be technically a perfect vocalist, but I much prefer vocalists that I can actually feel, like, when they're singing.
Yes.
And she's exactly that.
I agree. Which is a perfect segue to our next song. Our next song being IU's Love Wins All. I have heard this once because I don't know if you can tell. I really love IU. One of my favorite artists. So I just had to listen to it once. I needed to get it out. I couldn't wait. It made me cry. I don't expect to not cry this time. Anna, what do you know about this song?
Nothing. I love IU. Okay, I'll preface with that. Some of these artists I haven't heard before. I know IU like the back of my hand. So I'm very excited. But I haven't... I'm going in blind. I haven't seen anything, heard anything. And if it can make me cry, that's a true testament to how powerful.
I have tissues already.
I don't.
Okay. Good luck.
I'm very excited.
I'm not ready.
Oh, the movie.
Oh, and this is someone from BTS is in this. I forget who. Does it tell us?
Is that not V? Am I wrong?
It might be V. I don't know.
I can't see. It's V.
Oh, it is? Okay. I don't know any of the members.
Oh,
all tattered up and running from that cube.
One thing IU's gonna do, she's gonna bring in a BTS member.
Yeah, she did with Suga.
Oh, he's got like a odd eye. I swear to God.
No, he's...
Or is he blind?
Blind in that eye.
Sorry, everything's out of circle. Dearest, darling, my
universe, my teddy goes for me. If there's like a queen of emotional singing,
yeah,
it's gonna be IU. With the feel of that old camera. Mm. It's so pretty.
God, this feels like a lullaby, like something you would sing to your child.
The set design is so pretty, too. Ew, that food's dirty. Ew.
Oh, the change between shots were, like, through the camera.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Oh my god, troublemakers.
What the fuck? God.
They're so cute.
And what's sad is, like, in the camera, he didn't even have that blindness in his eye.
No, they're just their younger selves. They're so cute. Ooh, chills. The instrumentals are so pretty too. It's like a whole orchestra. Go fuck off somewhere else.
The swell.
Oh, I love it's so cute. I love when the song slows down and it's a little acoustic part.
It's the most intense shit ever.
Oh my god.
I have full body chills.
Oh, he's crying too, and she's crying, and I'm crying, and my cats are crying.
Oh, the camera. It's just the clothes.
That's so mean. Let me see if there's more. No. Okay, what did you think while I recover?
I was choked up through the whole thing. I was so quiet because I couldn't even like speak. I had full body chills towards the end when it was like the instrumental was swelling and everything was coming into place. And then, you know, IU's voice is just hitting like, you know. Mm-hmm. Well, I'm talking a lot about my favorite artists today. But another one of my favorite artists is this artist named Sleeping At Last. And he just does wonderful, like, emotional music with, like, the orchestra in the background. And we were just talking about it with Solas. My favorite artists are the ones who make me feel something.
Yeah.
And, you know, it's so interesting how a song where you can't understand the lyrics can make you feel so much, you know? I've never doubted IU before. Like, I always know she's going to create a hit and something good and something that's going to, you know, bring me some type of emotion. But I think this is the number one for songs that have hit me. Like, I feel it.
Yeah. She has a couple of those songs for me. IU's always hitting my feels.
I also like, it's so interesting because this is kind of the opposite of that. But one of my other favorite IU songs is Through the Night. And that is for the same reason. It makes me feel things, but it's the opposite. Through the Night is so calm, essentially all the way through. And this one, it takes you on a journey. I told you, when I, you know, in the beginning, I was like, this feels like she's singing a lullaby. And by the end, it sounds like she's singing in pain, you know?
Yeah.
So, holy shit.
The music video was also just so well done. The set designs were amazing. The part that always gets me in is when that block or whatever is coming towards them and IU covers his good eye.
So he can't see it.
That's just mean.
Claps for V.
Mean to us. Like, why you gotta make me feel all that?
Claps for V as well. Great job acting.
Yes, good job. I don't know you, but good job.
I thought that was so good.
And finally, our last song is going to be Twice's I Got You. And we love Twice here. Me and Anna have gone to multiple concerts for them together.
Yeah.
So we're just big fans. I know nothing about this music.
All I know,
no teasers or anything
about this, is that someone posted on their bubble, one of the members, I can't remember who, they were saying that they all wanted this, like, this was, like, so close to being a title track.
It's not?
It's pre-release. End of the month, I think, is their actual title, which we will be reacting to. But this is, they said it was kind of like by the title, you know, a song for each other, I think. It was like a family song. Like, kind of like Feel Special is a song towards each other, you know? But I don't know anything about how it sounds. I do know a little bit. I watched the first teaser, I think. But I don't know anything else. I'm very excited. And I heard they got budget, so.
It looks like it from the first frame of this music video. Let's just dive in.
It's budget already. They got the like CGI.
I can't even tell if this is CGI or not.
I think it is.
It looks so real. Oh. Ooh, cool.
Ooh. One Piece. Ooh,
hello, Nina. Oh, they're going like 80s funky vibes.
Ooh, the bass.
Jonghyun.
Not the vibe that I thought it would go, but I like it.
Not at all. Oh, she's so pretty.
Oh, Jonghyun.
That's my bias right there.
Ooh. Where the fuck are they? Ooh, the deep Dayeon.
Nayeon's voice is always just so fun to listen to. Oh, they're so cute.
I love them so much. Hey, every second, every minute, when you're close to me like it's supposed to be, and the limit.
Oh, that was cool.
Ooh, the instrumental is really fun in the background.
Yeah.
Aww.
That's cute. Is this all in English? But I think it's all in English.
It might be. Ooh,
I love
the choreo.
The chorus.
Crazy good. It's very flowy.
Is this Gio singing?
Right now?
No, it's Nayeon.
And Gio's in the background, I think, layered on top of that. This is budget. This is crazy. I don't think JYP's ever given them this budget.
Oh, and then an animated bit. I wonder if this is in the song itself or if this is for the music video. I don't like ASMR, but this is making my... I don't know if it's cool.
Why did they get... They've never gotten that much budget before. I'm not kidding.
It's about time.
They deserve it. Absolutely.
They bought a whole Mina a whole yacht just for this music video. I thought it was... Okay, that's what I was expecting.
Ooh, Gio.
I hope they kept that yacht.
It's theirs. They bought it.
It's theirs.
There's something about, I guess, February or January and February where artists are just releasing songs with really emotional vocals and emotional lyrics. And then, like, you know, like, this was really good. It's so interesting because I wasn't sure where they were going to go from Set Me Free was, you know, well, I guess Moonlight Sunrise. It was super, well, it was nighttime. That was like the vibe, right? So even though it wasn't super like, it wasn't super upbeat, it was a little more smooth. This is so much more, it's like daytime. Literally like daytime. Mm-hmm. So I wasn't...
This is also...
What?
Go ahead.
Oh no, you go ahead.
This is also one of those driving around with your friends, windows down.
Yep.
Let's have a good time today.
That's like...
Drink some White Claws or something.
One of my favorite vibes of songs. And Twice has done this a couple times before with some other songs. I'm like, oh yeah, these are driving around, windows down songs. This might be my I'm gonna make a bold claim, one of my favorite songs, top five favorite songs on first listen. Ooh. Like, obviously some songs grew on me and then like became my favorite song, but on first listen I've enjoyed this so much. Like,
I did too. I was just smiling the whole time because it was so feel good. And it did sound like one of those, you know, for themselves type songs. And I just love them so much. And so I was so happy just listening to them, like, basically, like, love each other.
It
love being a group.
They love each other so much. It's so sweet. Yeah, I think it hits different when you know that they, like, this is a song for each other. I got you, you know? Also, I think, like, I really like the pre-chorus. I'm also a sucker for, like, Dayeon's low vocals. So when Dayeon, like, hit really low, I was like, oh my god, yes. The vocals were really good in this. The instrumental, you guys will see in the reaction. I couldn't stop bopping my fucking head.
Like, yeah, me too. I was constantly conscious of that.
It was so... It was simple, but not in a way that was like, oh, this is simple pop that, like, anyone could write. This felt simple in a good way. Visuals insane. Everyone looked insane.
Always.
So good. The budget, the music video was gorgeous. I love the little animated part in the middle. It kind of felt like a,
Ooh, that was cute.
A storybook, which is cute because it's Twice started out with like story themed Their first album was what? The Story Begins. So, very cute. Outfits were cute. The choreo, we didn't see, I feel like, that much. Or at least the shots were kind of strange when we saw it. But from what I saw, it looked really fun and, like, flowy. I'm so excited for their actual comeback. Like, I cannot wait. If this is, like, the quality that they're bringing.
I am very excited. So that was our reaction to all of those music videos you just watched. I had a great time. Loved all of them, pretty much. If you liked that, then feel free to give us a little comment. Let us know what you thought. Like the video, subscribe, and we will see you guys next time.
Bye.